Hello viewers, good morning. Welcome to our channel Appa Public School, and I am Ajay Dutt, your biology teacher. So students, so in yesterday's class, so we were dealing with Mendelian genetics, and I have said you about the Mendel's law. So in today's class, we are going to deal with the Mendel's law and their explanation. Okay. So Gregor John Mendel, he has made three laws. Out of them, the first law is law of dominance. Second one is law of purity of gametes, and third law is law of independent assortment. So these three laws were proposed, or these three laws were made by Gregor John Mendel on the basis of his observations, taking the experimental plant as Pisum sativum, that is garden pea plant. So he has given three laws, that is law of dominance, law of purity of gamete, and law of independent assortment. So let us first know about the statements of all these laws, and then the concept or explanation of these laws. Okay, law of dominance. So law of dominance, what does it states? So law of dominance states that in an heterozygous condition, so let me tell you what you mean by heterozygous condition. In the definition, we are already knowing about the heterozygous condition. So see, this is the sperm, this is the egg. Okay, sperm carries a gene for character length. Okay, this is the allele which sperm is carrying. Okay, so this is the allele for the character length which egg is carrying. Right, so this is one of the situation. This is one of the situation, or this is one of the condition. Okay, so the offspring would be having two alleles, that is capital T and small t. Capital T and small t are allele, these two are the alleles for the character length of the individual. Okay, this is one possibility. In some cases, what is happening, that sperm is carrying the allele T, and egg is also carrying the allele T. So when both the sperm and egg fuses, the zygote will be having both the alleles, that is capital T and capital T, right? So such a condition where both alleles are identical, that condition is called as homozygous condition. Or in some cases, sperm is also carrying small t chromosome, that is allele, and egg is also carrying small t, both fuses, small t, this is also homozygous condition. But this is a heterozygous condition. Heterozygous condition because the alleles are not identical. They are similar. Both are alleles for length itself, but they are not identical. One of them is dominant and the other one is recessive. So what do you mean by dominant gene? I have already said you that the dominant allele or the dominant gene is the one which is going to suppress its partner and expresses itself externally. So that is phenotypically it is going to express itself.
itself. So such a gene which is going to express itself by suppressing its partner gene is known as a dominant gene, is known as a dominant gene. So here both of them are recessive, both of them are dominant. So homozygous, both of them are homozygous, and this is heterozygous. So this is heterozygous. Now understanding the law of dominancy. So what does this Grigor-John Mendel say, or what does this first law say? So first law says that whenever you cross two organisms, okay, whenever you cross two organisms which are heterozygous in condition, such as you take the character, okay, apple. Okay, apple is red in color. Red apple is one of the variety. Red apple is one of the variety which is available in our local markets, and that allele for this red apple is represented as capital A. Okay, capital A, capital A. And one more apple is the green apple. Apple, okay, or it is simply called as Granny Smith, because in 1868 probably, so Granny Smith in Australia was the one who cultivated such variety of the apple. People have a confusion, or they are not having a clarity between apple and a green apple. Apple, it is green when it is not ripened, and it turns red or blackish red when it is ripened, okay, but green apple, it is green itself when it is not ripened, and after ripening it is turning into yellow color, not complete yellow, but straw yellow color. Okay, that is the difference between a green apple and a red apple, that is a normal apple. People have confusion that unripened apple is nothing but green apple. No, green apple is something different from the normal apples. So you can take example of the oranges and the lime. Okay, so oranges and the sweet lime, Mosambi and Santra. Okay, people have problem, or people have confusion that the oranges which are unripened, they are nothing but Mosambi. No, okay, Mosambi is something different and oranges are something different. Of course both of them belong to the citrus family itself, but they are different. Okay, so with all this clarity, we'll begin with this one. Okay, the normal apple or the red apple is having allele capital A, capital A, and the green apple are having the allele small a, small a. So I say that red apples are dominant and green apples are recessive. So when you cross both these varieties, or when you hybridize both these varieties. So I am using the term hybridization. So what do you mean by hybridization? The crossing of two genetically dissimilar organisms to get the offspring of the desired quality. So what do you mean by hybridization? Hybridization means crossing of two genetically different organisms to get the offspring of our desired quality. So that is called as hybridization. So when you are hybriding, or when you are crossing the red apple variety with the green apple variety, so you get a progeny out of it. That is, these are the parents. So you get a gametes. Gamete means half, you already know. So half number from father side, half number from mother side. So half, that is 1A, half A. So when both the gametes of the green apple and red apple combine, you get a hybridized apple. Is that clear? That is the hybridized apple which you are going to get. So this is known as F1 generation. You know, you can just tell them as
first clear generation or F1 generation.
F1 generation. Is that clear? Is that clear? So this is an F1 generation, which is heterozygous, which we have obtained from homozygous red apple and homozygous green apple. Means simply homozygous means pure parents. Heterozygous means impure parents. Okay. So among these two alleles, only one of the alleles is going to express, and always the dominant allele is going to express. Therefore, the hybrid apple which you have obtained is red in color. Is red in color externally, but internally it is having the gene of green apple also. So therefore, it is a heterozygous red apple. Okay, so homozygous means pure one. So inside the body of the organism, the genes are also similar, and that the genes are going to express itself. That is why they are homozygous in condition. Okay, same in case of green. Inside the body, they are having the genes for green color. Externally also, the apple is green in color. But when you are crossing, you are getting a combination of two different varieties. But still, this combined one is having the character of one of the parent. Is having the character of one of the parent. That means, internally it is having the character of mother and father. But externally, it is expressing the character of its father. Therefore, the father allele is dominant over the mother's allele. So, in such a condition, it is called as heterozygous one. It is called as heterozygous one. Okay. So, what are the possibilities of the combination of the red apple and the green apple? I will just tell you, okay? You go to a market, and when you go to a market, you have two varieties of apple. One is the green apple and the other one is red, okay? I will just write into the writing only. Okay, red apple, other one is green apple. Okay, so red apple, what are the genetical possibilities, or which type of genes they may be having? They may be having. So, they may be having either both of the genes may be in homozygous condition, or it may be a heterozygous condition. It may be a heterozygous condition. Homozygous, both of them are dominant, so of course the apple will be red in color. Heterozygous, one of them is dominant, so definitely other one is, this is going to express itself externally. Therefore, the apple looks red in color, but it is having the gene of green color also within it. So, I am having the gene of my mother and father. Only my father gene is going to express, whereas my mother gene is going to be suppressed, but it is still present in our gene. So, as same with your parents also. So, that is why you sometimes you have the height of your father, that is, you get the length of your father, your brother gets the color of your mother. Okay. So, in case of your brother, what is happening? The length is recessive, whereas the length of your mother is dominant over there. Okay, but in your case, your father genes are dominant, your mother genes are recessive. That is why you among your siblings are similar. You may be similar, but you are definitely not identical. So the gene which you may be having may be dominant in you, but the same gene would, for that particular character, may be recessive in case of your brother or sister. That is why, okay. So, a red apple may be having the allele that is pure A, that is homozygous one, or heterozygous. But what in case of green one? As I have already said you that the green apple is recessive one. So, therefore, you may be having only one combination, that is small a. Okay.
Why small a, small a? Because both of them are homozygous in condition and they express it themselves in absence of dominant gene. So there is no dominant gene among themselves. So when there is no dominant gene among themselves, they are itself going to express them. Okay, they are itself going to express themselves in the next generation. So whatever expressions you are looking at morphologically, they are called as phenotype. That is called as the phenotype. So that is the characters which you appear externally or which are expressing externally, they are called as phenotypes. And the characters which are hidden inside, they are called as the genotypes. That is sum of genetic makeup. So this is the genetic makeup. Okay, but externally red, green. So genetically these both are dissimilar. That means genotypically this is heterozygous, genotypically this is homozygous, but phenotypically both are red. So this is genotypically homozygous, but phenotypically also, because of absence of a dominant gene, the recessive gene is going to express itself. So now coming to Mendel's first law, that is law of dominance. So what does this law of dominance states? So law of dominance states that whenever you cross two homozygous parents, you obtain a heterozygous parent. Okay. So you take a pure tall plant. What did Mendel do? He crossed one pure tall plant with one pure short plant. Pure means homozygous. So do not use the word pure over there. It would be better if you use homozygous and heterozygous. Pure, impure, it is for your understanding sake. Okay. So whenever you cross a homozygous tall plant with homozygous short plant, you get a progeny. Okay. These are the parents. Half of them will be the gamete. When both gametes fuse, you get an offspring that is called as F1 generation. Got it. He says that among this F1 generation, only dominant gene is going to express, whereas the recessive one is not going to express. So this was partially accepted. But universally it was not accepted because of certain deviations. What is Mendel saying? So when you cross two pure parents, you get the impure offspring, and that impure offspring, one of the gene is going to express, the other one is not going to express. This itself is called as law of dominance. Okay. So one of the gene is dominant over the other gene. But this law, that is law of dominance, is not accepted universally because of certain deviations. So he has made his observation that only one of them is going to express, other one is not at all going to express. So that means your father is black in color, mother is fair in color, that is she is white in color. So they have a children, okay, and among all those children, all of them are black in color. This is said by Mendel, because Mendel has observed that all the offsprings were black in color. So he said it over all the children's. No, it is not the same case. One of the kid may be black color, one of the kid may be white in color, one of the kid may be combination of both that white and black, that is in the middle somewhat brownish color. Yes or no? So that is the deviation of Mendel's law. So there are concepts like incomplete dominance and codominance. What is this incomplete dominance and codominance?
Mendel is saying that all the dominant genes are going to express compulsorily. But what happens in certain situations? So this dominant gene is expressing in a partial way, in an incomplete way. So that is called as incomplete dominance, and which is proving this law of dominance as a false one. Because the dominant gene must express itself, but it is expressing in an incomplete way, in a half way, in a partial way. So that itself is deviating the law of dominance. Then how do we understand this incomplete dominance? By understanding one plant, that is Mirabilis jalapa. So it is commonly called as 4 o'clock plant, okay, which is opening only during the 4 o'clock of evening, that is the afternoon 4 o'clock, okay. Name is 4 o'clock plant or Mirabilis jalapa. So this 4 o'clock plant, one of the variety has red color, the other variety has white color. Okay, what is Mendel saying? When you cross a red variety with a white variety, so offsprings must be either red color or they must be white color. This is said by Mendel. But what is happening in this 4 o'clock plant? So when you are crossing a red color variety flower plant with a white color variety flower plant of a 4 o'clock plant, or simply commonly called as Mirabilis jalapa, commonly called as 4 o'clock plant. Okay, this is scientific name. Mirabilis jalapa is the scientific name of the flower. Okay, so you can just look into the net, or you can just Google it about the Mirabilis jalapa. So there the images are available. What do you mean by Mirabilis jalapa? Okay, it is almost a type of weed plant, commonly found growing near the your compounds and all those things. You can be very similar to them. Okay, so when people crossed a white variety of plant with a red variety of plant there, so what happened there? They must get red or white according to Mendel, but they got pink color. They got pink color. Okay, Mendel says they must either get red or they must get white, but they got pink. That itself is the deviation of Mendel's law. Because of this, Mendel's first law of dominance is not accepted. It is now not called as a law itself. Okay, one more case is codominance. This was incomplete dominance, okay? This is incomplete dominance. Next one is codominance. Next one is codominance. You take example of your blood group. So we are having blood group A, B, AB, and O. Simple method of classifying the blood groups. A, B, AB, and O. It is commonly called as ABO method of blood group determination. Okay, ABO method. Okay. So when you cross parent with blood group A and parent with blood group B, so what are all the combinations? You must get either A or B, but you may also get blood group AB or blood group O. So this is the beauty of genetics. Okay, when you are crossing A and B, you must either get blood group A. Your father is blood group A and mother is blood group B, having blood group B. You must either have blood group A, that is from your father's side, or B from mother's side. So what is happening? You are getting both the blood groups, that is AB blood group, both the combination. That means both of them are dominant. Here, father's is dominant, so you get A. Mother's is dominant, you get B. Both of them are dominant, you are getting AB. Both of them are recessive, you will get O. So this is the deviation of Mendel's law. Whatever Mendel is saying, that only dominant gene is going to express, it has been proved wrong, because dominant one
and recessive one, both of them are there, but still both of them are dominant over in this condition. So you are getting the blood group AB. Both of them are recessive, you are getting blood group O. Both of them are recessive, you are getting blood group O. You got it? So this is the deviation of Mendel's law. Therefore, Mendel's first law was not accepted. Okay. It is now not called as a Mendel's law. Okay. So law of dominance is not regarded as a law now. Okay. So this is all about the Mendel's first law. Mendel's first law. Okay. So what does Mendel's first law say? So whenever you cross two homozygous organisms, so you get a heterozygous organisms, and in that heterozygous organism, the dominant gene is going to express itself by suppressing the partner gene. So this was proved wrong. This was proved wrong. Then second example is, second law is law of purity gametes. What is this law of purity of gametes say? Law of purity of gametes says that during formation of the gametes, the alleles separate from each other and only one of them is going to enter into a gamete. So Mendel says that during formation of the alleles, during formation of the gametes, the alleles separate, and those separated alleles enter into the gametes. This is said by the Mendel in his second law, that is law of purity of gamete. So when you cross a tall variety, that is homozygous plant, with a short heterozygous plant, you obtain the progeny, that is heterozygous tall plant. So this is F1 generation, right? So when you cross such F1 generations with one more F1 generation, so what is happening? Their gamete formation will be there. These are parents, the sperm and the egg, then you, then your gametes, that is capital T, comma, small t. This is itself the segregation. I'm just putting a comma here because they both are separating now. They are representing their pure grandparents. Over here. So this itself is nothing but the law of purity of gametes. So when you cross two pure parents, you get an impure parent. And when you cross this impure parent with one more impure parent, you get the gametes as pure grandparents. That is why I am putting a comma between the capital T and small t. This itself is called as law of purity of gametes. So explanation of law of purity of gametes, we are having one explanation, and that is nothing but the monohybrid cross. So what is this monohybrid cross? What do you mean by monohybridization? So hybridization, I have already said you that the crossing up of two genetically different organisms to get the offsprings of desired quality, that is called as hybridization. Then what is this monohybridization? The hybridization of two genetically different organisms with reference to one character. Suppose I am taking the character of skin color. Okay, I am crossing two organisms with reference to only one character, that is known as monohybrid. Mono refers to single, hybrid refers to crossing up of two different organisms. Okay, the crossing up of two genetically different organisms with reference to single character is known as monohybrid cross,
And what do you mean by dihybrid cross? The crossing up of organisms with reference to two characters. I will take skin color and length. Okay. So I am taking two characters, and with reference to two characters, I am crossing two organisms. That is called as a dihybrid cross. That is called as the dihybrid cross. Monohybrid cross, the crossing up of genetically different organisms with reference to single character is known as monohybrid cross. And crossing up of two genetically different organisms with reference to two characters is known as dihybrid cross. And hybridization, crossing up of two genetically different organisms to get the progeny of desired quality, it is known as the hybridization. So what did Mendel do? So Mendel crossed two plants with reference to one character, that is length of the plant, that is length of the plant. So he took one tall variety of pea plant, he took one tall variety of pea plant denoted as capital T, that is homozygous, crossed with one short pea plant represented as small t. Okay, I have already said you about the seven pair of contrasting characters, that capital T, that is the tall plants are dominant over the short plants. So what is happening in his monohybrid cross? So gamete formation, these are parents, okay, they're gametes now. Okay, so gametes means half, so one gamete, so half one gamete. So these gametes fuse together to get F1 generation, that is capital T small t. Okay, capital T small t, this is F1 generation. So F1 generation, you either self pollinate or cross it with one more F1. You cross one, you got F1. You crossed one pure tall plant with one pure short plant. You got impure tall plant, because this is dominant. Whenever capital letters are there, you must think that it is going to express itself. Compulsory, they are going to express it themselves. So this one is going to be impure tall plant. So this impure tall plant, you are crossing with one more impure tall plant. You are crossing it with one more impure tall plant. So what is happening when you are crossing two heterozygous plants? So what is now next, gametes will be there. These will grow, develop, and then they must form their gametes, then they must reproduce, right? Their gametes. So during gamete formation of this F1, the gametes separate. They are going to segregate themselves. This is nothing but the law of purity of gametes. So when you cross these two, so you can cross them in a checker box. You can just cross them in a checker box or in a Punnett's square. It is called as a checker box or in a Punnett's square. So just make three columns, three rows, okay, out of which one mention for sexes. You take one of them as father, one of them as mother, or one of them as male and one of them as female. So T comma T, mother side, T comma T. So now you cross them.
capital T into capital T, capital T, capital T, capital T into small t, capital T, small t.
Always mention about the letters in upper cases, okay?
Small t, capital T. So it will be capital T, small t and small t. It would be small t and small t, okay?
So this is the possible combination of the, this is the possible combination of the offsprings in F2 generation.
I'm just crossing them over to mention that they are gametes, and these two are, these four are F2 generations. So parents, their gametes, then their offspring. That offspring is going to grow, develop and marry one more same variety. When it is going to marry one more same variety, it must produce its gametes. And when it is producing its gametes, fusion of these two gametes takes place in a checker box. You can represent it in a checker box or in a Punnett's square or a table. So these are the F2 generations. These are the F2 generations. F2 generations. Which of them are F2 generations? Capital T, comma, capital T, small t, small t and small t. These three, these four are the F2 generations. These four are the F2 generations. Now, when you look at this F2 generation, you must also know the genotypic ratio and phenotypic ratio. That means you must know the ratio at how much, how many of them are homozygous and how many of them are heterozygous. Then phenotypically, how many of them are expressing, genotypically, how many of them are inside the organism. Okay. So the genotypic ratio or the phenotype, first we'll write about genotypic ratio. Then pheno, genotypic and phenotypic ratios. Okay. So when you are mentioning about the genotypic and the phenotypic ratio, now genotypic ratio. So when you look into the genes, you must know whether they are homozygous or heterozygous. So this is a homozygous one. This is a homozygous one. Okay. So one is homozygous, tall plant. Two are heterozygous tall plants. Third, that is last one, is homozygous short plant. So the genotypic ratio of the monohybrid cross is one pure tall, two impure tall, one pure short. Homozygous tall, heterozygous tall, homozygous short plant. This is the genotype. That means you're looking into the genes of that organism. When you're looking at into the genes of that organism, it is very clearly visible that one is pure tall gene, two of them are having impure tall genes, and one is having pure short gene. Out of four offsprings, they got 50%, okay? That is 25 plus 50 plus 25. 25 of them are pure tall plants, 25% of them are pure short plants, and rest 50% are impure tall plants. That is 25, 50, 25, total 100. So out of 100 kids, 25 kids are tall, pure tall, 50 of them are impure tall, and rest 25 of them are pure short offsprings. This is about the genotypic ratio of that monohybrid cross. Genotypic ratio of that monohybrid cross. You got it? this is the genotypic ratio of monohybrid cross. Then coming to the phenotypic ratio, what is this phenotypic ratio? Phenotypic ratio means externally when you look at them, how do they appear? Either they are appearing tall or short. That is the thing you are going to look into. You are not bothering about internally whether they are having pure gametes or not and all those things. No. Internally whether they are having pure genes or not, you are not bothering about them. Phenotypical means externally what are they going to express. Genotype means both externally and internally what are they. That is important in genotype. Phenotype, whatever they are expressing, only that one you need to consider. So when you look at them, now we were a first time you looked into their genes. Now we are looking at their appearance. When you are looking at their appearance, this is also a tall plant. These both are also a tall plant, and this is a short plant. So when you look at them phenotypically, the ratio seems to be 3 tall plants is to 1 short plant. So therefore, the genotypic ratio of monohybrid cross is 1 is to 2 is to 1, whereas the phenotypic ratio is 3 tall plants is to 1 short plant. So genotypic means you are looking into their genes and you are saying whether they are homozygous or heterozygous. Homozygous tall, heterozygous tall, homozygous short. So phenotypically external appearance, 3 of them are tall, 1 of them is short. So genotypic ratio is 1 is to 2 is to 1, whereas phenotypic ratio is 3 is to 1. So this is what we have learned in today's class regarding the Mendel's laws of genetics or Mendel's laws of inheritance. The first law which was not accepted is the law of dominance. The second one is law of purity of gametes. And in next class we would be dealing with one more law, that is law of independent assortment, which is the third law proposed by the Mendel. Till then, signing off. Thank you.